Well, there we see Susie O'Neill warming up for the race of her life. And how could we forget her 200 freestyle last night? And I thought that she would just qualify in an inside lane for the semi-final after the semi-final of the 200 fly, but she is a racer. She wants to win, and she hasn't been defeated in 6 years.
The start list for the final, the lane assignments. O'Neill in four, Patria Thomas in five. Zaychuk in three, maybe the main danger. Misty Hyman in six, not without claims.
Now expect Patria Thomas to go out reasonably fast in this first 100. And that's good for Susie, because she tends to go out a little bit slower. So if Patria can drag Susie out, that means we could get Susie into a world record time position. I don't want to predict a world record here, but she is looking very good. And I just want to make sure that we see Australia go one and two. Now for Patria, she needs to go out fast to get herself into a good position so that she can medal in either the gold or the silver position.
Maki Mita in lane one from Japan.
Qualified in 208.13.
Maki Mita. Jacobson in lane number two, second of the European Championships.
Qualified in 208.11.
Natalia Zaychuk in lane number three. This is the European champion, just 16 years of age, lives in Krakow.
Qualified in 207.81.
In lane three, a swimmer ranked number three on this year's world performances, representing Poland, Otilia Chinczak.
Getting ahead of ourselves there, that's Zaychuk.
This is what 18,000 people have come to see.
Gold in the 200-meter freestyle at this Olympics.
Lane four, Susie O'Neill.
Representing Australia, Susie O'Neill.
She laboured so long looking for gold. Eventually it came in Atlanta. And now the chance of two and two nights.
World record holder, 205.81, qualified in 207.57.
This has been in Atlanta. The bronze and silver medalist in the 1998 World Championships.
Silver medalist. World Championships
Australia,
and in Atlanta.
Patria Thomas
in lane five.
Patria has been a great battler over the years. She's been plagued with shoulder problems, and she's still at the top of the table. Fantastic ambassador.
Lane six, the American, Misty Hyman.
Third at the Pan Pacific in 99 and qualified in 207.87.
Like the Australians, two Americans side by side in this race. Caitlin Sandoneau out in seven.
Sandoneau in 209.40. It was a personal best for her, and she got second at her American trials.
Representing the United States of America, Caitlin Sandoneau.
I expected a lot of this girl coming in. So far, it's been a little disappointing. Lane number eight, Yuko Nakanishi from Japan.
Qualified also in a personal best at 209.89. This event was first held in 1968. And the time it was won in was 224.70. And the world record now is 205.81.
So Susie O'Neill looking to defend her title at the Olympics. And you think back to Dawn Fraser in 1960 in the 100 freestyle.
Just watch how differently Susie O'Neill and Patria Thomas swim their races. Expect Patria to go out fast and then Susie to come home strongly.
So they're on their blocks. Great chance for Australia this.
Take your mark.
And away. Patria got the best of the starts. The silver medalist in Atlanta, up and stroking early as Susie, the gold medalist in the 200 freestyle last night. The gold medalist in Atlanta. And Zaychuk away with them, the European champion, going quickly across in lane six. The American Misty Hyman, the bronze medalist in Perth and at the Pan Pacs. Coming through Patria, she may be just in front. Thomas in front of Hyman. And now O'Neill joining in. Ed Zaychuk going quickly as well across in lane three as they complete 50.
Well, I saw Patria's coach, Mark Reagan, giving her a real pep talk before this race. She may be ready. She's going out after it. And she's going to make Susie work. There's no doubt about that. She wants this win. Misty Hyman's coming up in lane six, looking fantastic at this stage of the race.
Thomas around first. Hyman going very quickly has claimed the lead. Hyman in lane six. O'Neill about a metre off the speed. The speed with the American down towards halfway. Misty Hyman. Thomas is second, and Zajac is working into it. O'Neill has got the job in front of it, but she comes home so strongly around halfway. 59.91 for Hyman. In second place is Thomas. O'Neill around third. Now she'll start to make her move. Can the American hang on? Misty Hyman in front. Thomas out after her, and O'Neill coming into the picture now.
And they're inside world record pace. Misty Hyman's in a dangerous situation there because Susie may not be able to see her. But here comes Susie. She's starting to pick up the pace.
About 65 metres to swim, and this crowd roaring. O'Neill charging after the American. Hyman maybe still in front, the final turn. Hyman is the leader. O'Neill within a stroke now. Thomas is back third, and Zajac is fourth. The American got a great turn. Misty Hyman suddenly has slipped away. O'Neill trying valiantly. Hyman's in front by about a body length. Susie's got a big job on her hands. Thomas is back third. The Australian's looking at silver and bronze. Well, can O'Neill find something? This has been a great swim by the American. Hyman is still in front. O'Neill is second. Thomas is third. Misty Hyman is going to win gold for the Americans. Misty Hyman comes in first. O'Neill gets second. Thomas is third. Jacobson is fourth. A boil over at the Sydney International Aquatic Centre. Misty Hyman cannot believe it.
Well, what a sensational race for Misty Hyman. 205.88, just outside the world record. She has broken the Olympic record, and she went out after it. And in that second lap, I just don't think Susie O'Neill could quite see her. But what an effort by the Australians. O'Neill second, and Patria Thomas came in third. What a magic moment at the pool here.
What a gutsy performance by Misty Hyman.
Here we see Patria Thomas congratulating Misty Hyman. And Madam Butterfly, Susie O'Neill, relinquished her title.
Evelyn Sandineau helping a teammate just in case she can't get those arms up. What a swim. Took it out in front, took it out hard, took on the best in the world. Great turn coming to the final 50. They went in on terms. I venture to say Hyman came out half a body length in front.
Yes, she really worked that third turn. And I just think in that second lap, Susie O'Neill couldn't quite see Misty Hyman because Patria Thomas was blocking her view. Susie did get a bad start there. Patria got an excellent start. And Misty Hyman, Olympic gold medalist.
Bronze medalist in Perth at the World Championships and at the Pan Pacs. Can't speak too highly of that effort. She cannot believe it. The realization will not sink in.
We see the underwater shot of Misty Hyman, and she just kept working at it. I thought she was going to fade, and here's Lindley.
Misty Hyman wins. Here's Lindley.
Susie, a great swim. Did you have any idea that Misty Hyman was over two lanes beyond?
I saw her right at the end, but you know, I was just concentrating my own race plan, so I have to be happy with that. It's the best I could do.
Did your freestyle events take it out from you a little bit? Or that was...
I'm not sure, but if I had known that, I would have got more excited last night when I won the Tournament Prix.
Patria, you must have wondered whether or not you're actually going to be here with those two shoulder reconstructions.
Yeah, I mean, it's great just to be here, and I did the best job I could tonight, so I have to be happy with that. It was a PB.
Congratulations.